Last couple of years, I've gotten the chance to work on great, funny things, 30 Rock, Curb Your Enthusiasm, you know, arguably the funniest things around, and this rivals that. It's David West Reed has written a play that is funny and sexy and sweet and sad and real. And, you know, it could be easily written off as the porn play. It's a love story. It's a romantic comedy set in this world.
Play Lee. He is not an adult film performer. He's, I guess you could say, he's the straight guy in this crazy little comedy. He's a journalist for the New York Post, and he's just coming into Vegas with his fiance for one night only to see his friend, played by Cheyenne Jackson.
I play Peeves, and she may be my favorite character to date, which is saying a lot because I love a lot of the characters I've played, but she is like this big beating heart and so open and sort of wide-eyed and trying to sort of navigate her world as adult performer and as wife and aging and potential motherhood and surprisingly wise and just hilarious. And you know, there's a sort of an unself-consciousness about her that I just love and I'm so excited to play with. You know, I think the biggest thing about this play is that it's a really fun setting to be at the Adult Entertainment Awards in Vegas and, you know, playing a performer, but at the same time, the play so is not about the porn world.
Is there any way that an up-and-coming starlet in adult film is similar to aspiring actors?
Oh yeah, especially in the musical theater world, bro. Do anything for a job.
One question, as a reporter, I would ask.
You love Broadway.
I would ask Henry Winkler where the Fonz jacket is.
The Fonz jacket is in the Smithsonian in Washington D.C. And when I go there, I visit.
If you were an adult film star, what would your name be?
Oh, isn't it the whole thing about your adult film name is the pet in the street you live on? So mine would be Patches Carpenter.
So mine is Conan Meadows. Come on. Conan Meadows, that writes itself.
How about Butterfly McCreary? Or Butterfly Wonderland?
That would be Yaya Hylage.
Maybe
there's a new job I can look forward to, and then I'll pan out to close early.
Constantly stroked.
That's a good one. Why?
I'm going to leave that to your imagination.
Backstage is a magazine for actors, so what advice do you have for aspiring actors?
Well, I was just telling you before we started the interview that I just was on the cover, which was such an amazing thing because when I was first starting out, using Backstage was the only way I found auditions, and I was a kid and it wasn't sold near where we lived, so literally my mom would drive into Cambridge every week to go pick up Backstage. And so anyway, that I just want to say that because I love magazine.
If you feel inspired and excited and you love it, then just that's what you continue to do. And if something happens where you get to have a career out of it, then that's a wonderful thing. But I think that the more important thing is to love how you're spending your life and your time. If it's miserable, you're not really enjoying it, but you have some end result you're looking for, that's just a recipe for disaster.
I think just be open, you know, be open to every kind of new experience that comes your way. Maybe not every experience, you know, don't know. But I'm, you know, and sort of, and be nice to people, you know, because people remember that.
You have to be ready to be told no way more than you're told yes. Tenacity and talent is the most important thing. And yeah, thick skin.
Tenacity. It is up to us. I do not wait for that phone to ring. I take my pick and my shovel and I mine the system every day. No matter who you are or what you have achieved, you're always at the starting line. I promise you. Your tenacity. You want it? If you will it, it is not a dream. And I cannot wait to act with you one day.